Hi, it's Katrina. You probably already know about some of the priciest materials on the planet, such as diamonds, but here are eight of the most expensive substances on Earth that will set you back a pretty penny. Some of them might surprise you. Number 8. Plutonium. Plutonium is an artificial, metallic, radioactive, and highly toxic chemical element that is valued at around $4,000 per gram. Although plutonium was already relatively expensive during the Cold War, the price drastically increased during the 1990s. Then, in 2008, the cost of plutonium skyrocketed from $200 per gram to its current price. Plutonium is only used for two general purposes: nuclear energy and nuclear weaponry. Some examples of specific uses for plutonium are as fuel for spacecrafts. It forms a dull coating when oxidized and vanishes when exposed to thin air. Since most people have no practical use for plutonium, one might be compelled to wonder why it's so pricey. One reason plutonium is so expensive is to deter people from being able to afford it for destructive acts. It is also only sold in tiny amounts to prevent any organizations or institutions from accumulating enough to cause any serious damage. The good news is that a license is required to handle plutonium, and even licensed individuals are often monitored while using the substance. Number 7. Painite. Painite is a borate material that very few people even know exists because of how rare it is. Before its official lab analysis, the precious stone was mistaken as a sapphire, and it's likely that some cuts were mistaken as rubies or garnets. It was first identified as a gem species in 1957, based on a single crystal, and was named after mineralogist Arthur Payne, not because it hurts. Painite is an ideal gem in several ways. It comes in beautiful shades of deep red and has a hardness of 8 on the MOHS hardness scale for gemstones. However, even gem-quality stones tend to be fractured and are challenging for professional gem cutters, who typically cut painite into small and shallow pieces, which unfortunately reduces their brilliance. At $9,000 per gram, you don't want to waste it! Until 2001, there were only three known painite specimens, two of which are currently housed at the Natural History Museum in London. Since then, more have been discovered, but the gem remains extremely rare and is only found in Myanmar. Number 6. Tritium. Tritium is a radioactive isotope of hydrogen. It's radioactive because it has two neutrons, unlike hydrogen, which has none. The two neutrons in tritium make it innately unstable and therefore radioactive. Tritium is produced naturally in the upper atmosphere by the interaction of cosmic rays with certain gases. It can also be man-made as a byproduct of nuclear reactors. This gas has several uses. It's commonly used as glow-in-the-dark lighting for signs and other products. To create luminescence, tritium is combined with phosphor and doesn't require any sort of electricity. Tritium is also useful in biomedical and academic research as a tracer. In some countries, it's used as thermometer fuel. Despite its frequent use in everyday products, tritium can be dangerous. When not closely monitored, tritium can seep into groundwater from nearby nuclear plants. And although it's safe for consumption in trace amounts, tritium can be toxic for humans and wildlife in high concentrations. The good news is that this cannot travel very far through air and also cannot penetrate human skin. And did I mention it's expensive? It's $30,000 per gram. It costs around $15 million to produce a pound of tritium, which means that very little of the gas is used for its more common uses. Number 5. Diamonds. They say that diamonds are forever, and it's evidently true. Diamonds are arguably the most well-known precious stone on the planet, and have been for a long time. At a cost of roughly $55,000 per gram, they are also one of the most expensive materials in the world. The popularity of diamonds goes back so far, the ancient Greeks and Romans believed they were tears cried by the gods or splinters from falling stars. There's also evidence that diamonds were traded in India as early as the 4th century BC. Some ancient societies even believed that diamonds had protective properties and used the stones for devotional religious statues or wore them as they rode into battle. Different countries have taken turns being the world's largest diamond producer. During the 1400s, it was India, who exported diamonds to various European trading centers, including Venice. India's diamond reserves declined in the 1700s, and Brazil became the world's biggest supplier of the precious gem from then until the late 1800s, when a huge reserve was discovered in, you guessed it, South Africa. The Cullinan diamond was the largest ever found. It was discovered in South Africa in 1905. Originally, it weighed in at 1.33 pounds or 3,106 carats until it was cut down. First, it was gifted to King Edward by the owner of the mine and the leaders of South Africa. Then, the diamond was cut into over 100 smaller gems. The three largest are on display as part of the crown jewels at the Tower of London, with the biggest being worth around $400 million. Diamonds are typically billions of years old and are one of the few things that get better looking as they age, apparently. They are nearly 100% carbon and are brought to the Earth's surface by deep volcanic eruptions after forming about 100 miles below the ground. They're also the planet's hardest substance and can only be scratched by another diamond. Number 4. Jadeite. There are two different minerals known as jade. Of the two, emerald green jadeite, or imperial jade, is the harder and rarer variety. Not surprisingly, it's also the more highly valued type at around $85,000 per gram. Appraising the value of a jadeite piece is complicated because on top of traditional mineral qualities, such as color and quality, things like artistry and antiquity are taken into consideration too. Therefore, it appeals mostly to collectors. Myanmar is the source of the finest known jadeite, just like painite. 70% of the world's gemstone quality jadeite is exported from the country. In 2016, the US lifted its embargo on importing the stone from Myanmar. That same year, a massive 192-ton jade boulder worth up to $170 million was discovered there. China has the strongest market for jadeite, which makes sense since the country is historically known for its love of the stone. Until 1863, jade was considered to be a single mineral. During that year, a French mineralogist named Alexis de Moore discovered that stones of two distinct mineral species, jadeite and nephrite, had been long classified as the same thing. However, the Chinese had already distinguished a difference between the two over a century earlier. Jadeite and nephrite have differing internal structures and properties, despite sharing an outward appearance. To this day, most people refer to both of them as jade. Number 3. Californium. Californium is a radioactive chemical element that was first synthesized from curium and alpha particles in 1950 at the University of California Radiation Laboratory in Berkeley. It's also the most expensive chemical element of all time. It comes with a hefty price tag of $25 million per gram. Only a few grams of the substance have ever been made, and only a half gram is manufactured annually, which is why it's so expensive. The costly chemical is produced in particle accelerators and nuclear reactors. Californium is primarily used for mineral prospecting as a portable source of neutrons for the detection of elements such as gold. It is also used for some medical treatments, including certain brain and cervical cancers that radiation therapy has failed to treat. Traces of the chemical can typically be found near facilities that use it for either purpose. Prior to 1980, a small amount of californium was contributed to the environment from fallout from atmospheric nuclear testing. Number 2. Francium. Francium was discovered in 1939 by French chemist Marguerite Catherine Perret and was named after the country of France. Now the name makes sense, right? It's considered a natural element but is very rare. Scientists estimate that at any given time, the Earth's crust contains no more than an ounce of francium. In fact, naturally occurring francium is so rare, scientists must produce it in order to study it. Thanks to francium's extraordinarily short half-life of only 22 minutes, this element costs an astounding $1 billion per gram. Since an entire gram of the extremely radioactive chemical element has never been observed, its price tag is theoretical. The biggest amount of francium ever produced was around 300,000 atoms. But this amount of the chemical, or even an entire gram of it, disappears within minutes of being created. There's no practical use for francium despite its exorbitant value. It's currently only used for scientific research. Number 1. Antimatter. The most expensive substance on Earth is antimatter. Antimatter is pretty much the same thing as matter insofar as their particles being practically identical. The difference between matter and antimatter is that their particles carry opposite charges and spins. It costs $25 million to produce just 1 milligram of positrons, the antimatter equivalent of electrons. While antimatter may seem like something of science fiction, it occurs fairly regularly in small amounts in the form of cosmic rays or energy particles from space that constantly rain down on Earth. Antimatter occurs even closer to us than that, believe it or not. Bananas, of all things, produce antimatter, releasing one positron every 75 minutes or so. Our bodies also produce positrons, but because they annihilate immediately upon contact with matter, we don't notice their very short-lived existence. Theoretically, antimatter will someday be used to fuel spacecraft. Unfortunately for now, it's too expensive. The cost of making just 1 gram of antimatter would roughly equate to all of humankind working nonstop for an entire year. Producing antimatter also requires enormous amounts of energy that is not currently at the widespread disposal of scientists. In some ways, this is a good thing, at least for now. Just 1 gram of antimatter is said to have the potential to cause an explosion the size of a nuclear bomb. If all the human-created antimatter were to disappear, it wouldn't even be able to boil a cup of tea. Therefore, we have a long way to go before positrons are used to blast rockets into space. Thanks for watching! Which of the items did you find the most intriguing? Let me know in the comments below. Remember to subscribe and come on over and say hi on Instagram at Katrina Explained. See you soon! Bye!